an individual. Right. Okay. Harvey. Oh, it does. I mean, parents must have hated that fucker.
We wanted a girl. Harvey.
Good old Harvey. That's Jimmy Stewart's rabbit's name, isn't it? Harvey. Yeah, that was it. Jimmy Stewart had the, wasn't it Jimmy? Yeah. Yeah, had a 6-foot rabbit named Harvey. Harvey's been around. Wow, you gotta quit eating those shrooms, dude. We still got a few minutes, we're fixing to go. Beats me. I better not think. Okay, I'll get a cue before you go on, right? Because I don't want to be sitting here smoking a cigarette if... Oops! I'm trying to quit. Oh, I am.
Bye.
insurance, no benefits, no nothing.
Really? They're back.
Okay, you're with Jake now. Hello?
Hello.
Hello?
I'm here.
How far away are we here, Jeff J?
We are 12 seconds into the window now.
Okay. Okay, have you guys called for IFB yet?
I hear IFB, I don't know what the... Harvey, are you around?
Harvey?
Harvey.
Harvey is currently getting wired up.
Oh, Harvey, you gotta quit that. I hear somebody that's... They're having a hard time with Harvey.
There, Jay, can you hear Harvey?
I do not hear Harvey.
You do not hear Harvey?
No, I hear them talking to Harvey, but I don't hear Harvey at all.
Okay.
They're wanting a mic check for him or something.
Mm-hmm. I need to have your producer call in with the IFB.
Oh, and that Punicello is turning 50. Isn't that exciting?
Is Jim Dennis there? Is Jim Dennis?
And that
Mike Weber? Is Mike Weber there?
Yeah, Mike Weber's here.
I can't get anybody here.
Mike Weber's here.
Nobody's responding.
You can't get a mic into your telephone?
Yeah, I think they're having problems. I think they're having problems.
Mike Weber is here. You guys can't get a mic into your phone. Is that the problem?
Mike Weber is in there.
You get 350, you can talk to me.
I don't know. These guys are on now. I don't know what's more important.
Yes, we having problems here? This is Mike Weber. Hello?
I'm here, Mike, but nobody else is.
Harvey? 203 293 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073 073
203-293-0791.
Okay, Harvey. Tell Harvey to talk to Jake now. It says here that we are supposed to call the Cincinnati IFB number.
What?
Cincinnati IFB dial-in phone number.
I can hear somebody talking about IFB phone number.
I'm dialing their number.
You are dialing them?
Yes, that's what it says down there. Hello?
Is this
Hello, Mike? Mike Weber, please.
Well, evidently not.
Yeah, Jake can hear you, and can you hear Jake?
Can Harvey hear Jake? Can Harvey hear Jake? I don't think so. Texas. Southern born, southern bred, when I die, I'll be southern bred. Whatever. I hear someone. Who am
Jake?
I talking? Yes.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
How you doing, brother?
Good. Who's this, Harvey?
This is Harvey.
In Hartford, huh?
Harvey in Hartford.
I like it.
Wait.
That surprises me. You usually so...
Wow, that was different.
We do things a little different in Connecticut.
I know that. I've spent some time there myself, Harvey.
All right. Let me see if these guys are rolling. I'm getting feedback here in my ear. Can we kill that feedback? Jake, where's the snake?
Oh, he's not here. You don't interview snakes, do you?
Well,
if you do,
you have it around your neck or something.
No, not these cobras. You don't put them that close to you. You have to be very careful. Something about the venom that seems to aggravate one's system.
Well, you're immune to that, I thought.
No, I don't think anybody is.
Oh, okay. Are we rolling, Jake? Okay. I can live with it. I mean, you want to roll? Okay. Ask them to... All right. Jake, if you can ask your guys on that end to cut my voice on their end. because we're getting like feedback and it's all screwed up.
Okay, our guys upstairs need to cut your voice on our end because it's giving too much feedback. Did anybody upstairs hear that? It's cut. Y'all have always been ready. Oh yeah, I stay excited when it's my money. Wouldn't you, Harvey? Yeah. Well, it's a challenge. It's a bigger challenge for him than it is for me. When you think about my mind, the way it turns. Basically, there are 12 matches on a wheel. You pull the lever, whatever match it lands on, that's what we're going to do. Now, you got things like a Russian chain match, a bull rope match, a Texas death match, Prince of Darkness. That's going to be tough. You know, I have to say, you know, there's one slot called a mystery match, so it would be up to me to come up with something. And if it does get down to the mystery match, I'd like to tell Sting his goodbye, because it's not going to be pleasant. Well, it won't be Trump, although he could probably use a break and some money. But no, Sting will spin the wheel. Once it starts turning, man, whatever it lands on, that's what we're going to do. So it's not going to be a deal where you're prepared for any certain thing. So that makes it a little more excitement. Everybody loves a mystery. And myself, if it did land on that mystery thing, I can just tell you there would be a large cobra involved in the match somehow, some way. Yeah. Well, somebody's going to go down. There's no doubt about that. All 12 matches are designed to hurt people. They're not, it's not a limbo contest or, you know, square dancing or anything. These matches are designed to basically to end one's career. Well, Harvey, I think in life you have to learn real quick there is no good and there is no bad. You just better go out and grab what you can. And that's basically the way I live. I have my own set of rules, you know. I don't try to make anybody else happy but myself. What you perceive me as being is your own business, because basically I don't really care what Harvey and Hartford thinks about me, because Harvey and Hartford has not sent me a check in years, you know. Well, yeah, there's going to be a lot of people. But when I'm dead and gone, I don't think it's really going to bother me at all. You know, I'm sure there's a lot of people out there pulling for Sting, and that's their business. If you want to pull for Sting, go right ahead. But it's not going to bother me at all. I mean, I don't let the people or anyone influence my feelings. Not at all. No, if he did, he'd have me pitching for the Braves tonight. Well, he should be. He should be. To have the best team in baseball and not be winning a series is ridiculous, but that'd be like saying the best athlete always wins. That's not what it's about. The best team doesn't always win. The luckiest team sometimes wins. But in wrestling, it's a one-on-one confrontation. It's not nine guys or 11 guys, and that's what I like about it. You know, I've always been a singles wrestler. I don't like tag team wrestling. Single wrestling, you go out there and you look a man in the eye and it's like, okay, it's you and me. And that's the part I like about it, because to get that adrenaline high, whether it's by putting your hand in somebody's mouth and knocking a few teeth out or breaking a leg or whatever you got to do to get the job done, that's what gets me by in life. I'm a sick puppy. Basically end his career, unfortunately. I mean, well, you think about something. If you're playing football and that defensive end rushes in and he clips that quarterback and they carry that quarterback off on the stretcher, he's a hero, isn't he? Why is it different for us? Well, no, I'm not out of a job. I'll never be out of a job, because one thing about talent, they always need talent. And I am talent. Cold, cruel, but fair. Just like a snake, brother. And good luck. Thank you, Harvey. I didn't like John Wayne either. Well, John's not bad.
He had a couple of good flicks. I did. And they always got shafted. It wasn't right. But then again, who wrote the script, right? Well, you should. You should. No, it's been a long time. And it may be longer before I'm back. I just, it's a free world, man. You got to do what you feel's right. As long as I want it to be. Yeah. I'm not sure anybody was happy about me leaving any area at any time in my career, because fortunately for me, I do have something about me makes people want to watch. Whether it's my talking or my actions in the ring or the snake or whatever it is. And we all know that good products are hard to find, but they're even harder to hold on to. I hope so. All right, man, be good. All right. One down, 11 to go. Somebody wants them to change the mic here. He said we have a second. Yeah. The wire where? Tape and the hair trick. Not the rake just falling out. Going to Corey in Chicago. I'm here. Got it. I skipped those chords in Chicago. I'm here. Mark, wake up. Quit looking at the wall. I'm doing great. How about you?
Sometimes. No, I think I'm from Kmart. I'm not really sure where I'm from at times. I'm originally from Texas, but southern born. Right. My guess what? Sounds fun to me. All right. Sure, I appreciate that.
I've always liked things that, involve a little mystery, have a little fun. I mean, you think about life, and if you got everything figured out right off the bat, then it's not very exciting. The spin the wheel, make a deal. That's my idea. And the thing for me is to put the other man in a defensive position where he has to figure out what he's going to do. Now, I know what I'm going to do. I've always known what I'm going to do. And for those that don't know where I'm headed, you have to look back and see where I've been. But the spin the wheel, make a deal, there are 12 matches on there, and they're all designed to basically end a man's career. Now you say, why do you want to end this man's career? Because to be the man, you have to beat the man. And unfortunately for Sting, he is the man. He's the man that WCW has put up on the pedestal and marketed and given to millions across the world to look at and to praise and to idolize. And I think it's time for a change. And there will be a change come Sunday. How would I compare Sting to some of the other great opponents? Well, another notch on the gun, I guess. I mean, he's a great athlete, no doubt about that. He's got a lot of guts. He'll fight you. He'll wrestle you. I've been in the ring with better wrestlers, but not many. But for a man to be great, he has to be proven over a period of time, and Sting has done that. And the only problem Sting has in life is he's got somebody called Jake the Snake looking down his throat saying, it's your turn. He should be concerned about everything. The DDT should be concerned about the Cobra, because I guarantee you, if it does land on the mystery slot on that wheel, there will be a very large Cobra involved in that match. I mean, that's up to me to decide there. And that's what I keep hoping for. Maybe I'm lucky, maybe I'm not. But in any event, in any time, if you look me in the eye and you think that you know what I'm doing, then you're sadly, sadly mistaken, because you made the biggest mistake of your life. By sticking a hand out and trusting a snake, you just don't do that. I'm having a hard time hearing you, Mark. Excuse me? Yeah, we're getting a lot of feedback, Mark. What are you doing in St. Louis? Okay, I can barely hear you now, but I think we can go with this. No doubt, only a fool wouldn't be. But I think Sting knows or has an idea what he's looking into, but I'm just not sure that he understands just how far I'll go with it. I mean, some people, they committed a crime and they stuck a hand out there and they've had a gun in their hand, they pull that trigger, and then 3 or 4 days later they say, well, gee, I wish I hadn't done that. Well, I'm not that way. If I make up my mind to do something and I do it, I'm not going to feel bad about doing it. And Sting needs to understand that I'm out there to end his career in any way that I can. It's nothing personal, mind you. It's just that He happens to be the one wearing the golden ring around his neck, man. I gotta take it. I've got to take it. You're gonna see a king cobra with enough venom in it to stop two bull elephants, and I'm not a bull, I'm not an elephant, so obviously it'll be just as dangerous for me as it will for Sting. But then again, I've never dealt with fear unless it was dishing it out. Sure. Chicago, I don't know why. Does anybody really care about that one? We'll go with Houston. Tampa. Philly, and I hate to admit it. It's time for the Giants to turn it around. Gotta go with the Skins, although I wish the Vikings would do it. Oh, you gotta go with San Diego. Denver's dead. Cleveland, we got another one that nobody really cares about, but we're gonna go with Cleveland. I'm going with Dallas. They're going to the Super Bowl, no doubt about that. Miami. Pittsburgh and Kansas City. I think you gotta go with Pittsburgh. Buffalo. Not much of a game, we don't say Buffalo. Tune in, guys, you'll enjoy it. A lot more than Sting anyway. Thank you, Mark. Well, yeah, their stuff turned up way too high. That is blowing me out over here. A guest prognosticator. Oh, man. Yes. Okay. All right. Mike, how you doing? Good luck. Well, this gentleman's taping something to me over here, so as soon as he's done, we'll be ready, Mike.
Here.
So you're nice and miserable in New York today? Okay, Mike, let's go. Well, that might be fun, but actually the deal Sunday night is spin the wheel, make a deal. It's something I invented. It's something for me to toy with. It's not going to be something pleasant for a gentleman named Sting. Unfortunately, all 12 matches on this wheel are designed to end a man's career. Now, a lot of people say, why do you want to end this man's career? Why not? What has he done for me lately? I mean, that's my attitude. The only way that you're going to be able to come out of this is to be very fortunate and to get the upper hand early, because I don't think any of these matches will last very long. They're all, like I said, designed to end a man's career. And Mike, you know, times are tough. And when times get tough, people go out a little bit further than they normally would. And I'm just telling Sting right now that I'm willing to sacrifice anything that I have to get the job done. Now, there happens to be one match on there, Mike, called the Mystery Slot. Everybody loves a mystery, don't they? They've always liked that mystery. So almost like a love affair at times, I guess. Except I would be the cheating husband if I was in that. But let me tell you, the mystery slot on this thing means that I can come up with anything that I want. That's a little bit scary when you consider the things that I've done in the past. And Sting should be aware of the fact that if it does wind up on that slot, you can surely bet that there will be a 12-foot cobra involved in it because, like I said, it's time to stop somebody. It's time to stop Sting. I always take it serious. I live with this face. I mean, people say, what's the toughest match you ever had in your life? It's every morning when I get up and look in that mirror and I gotta look and say, well, am I happy with myself today of what I'd done last night? You see, I'm the kind of guy that if I reach out and I take a gun and I shoot a man with it 3 or 4 days later, I'm not gonna feel bad about it. As far as Sting goes, to me, he's just a very unlucky man. Because no, I won't feel bad at all, I promise you that. I will not feel bad at all. I'm sure there's a lot of people out there that'd like to see me drop. But I'm not going to satisfy any of them. I'm going to satisfy myself, Mike. Well, maybe a barbed wire match. You know, in the ring surrounded with barbed wire, there's some, I don't know, I kind of get the warm feeling whenever I think about that. I mean, you think about somebody being tangled up in a little bit of barbed wire, that could be exciting in some form or fashion, as long as it's not me. Yeah, I guess it would. I guess it would. But the main thing is, Sunday night, somebody is going to drop. There's no doubt about that because none of the matches on this wheel are designed for an easy way out or a quick 1-2-3. It's going to be brutal. Well, that's cute. Of course, dead puppies are cute too, and cats drag well when they're dead. But the only thing, Mike, is that when you're dealing with athletes of the caliber of Sting or myself, you've got to consider the fact that we just didn't get here today. We've been here for a while. The only problem with the snake is he's been here since the beginning of time. Isn't he the one that changed Eve's mind? And that's what Sting needs to think about. He needs to remember just how long the snake has been around and what I will do and what I have done. Snakes believe in one thing, Mike, and that's surviving. Whether it means ending your life or ending the next man's life, it doesn't matter. I mean, we're here to survive. I've done things, I've got my own set of rules. I've always done what I've wanted to do. You may not like it, the next guy may not like it, but I really don't care because you're not sending me a check at the end of the week. You're not taking care of me. And even if you were, I might just reach out and get you too. It's just the way I am. Thank you, Mike. Enjoy New York. I'm glad you have to be there, not me. Really, brother. Yep. Okay, Denver. No problem. Yeah. I don't know what they're doing. They're changing their levels halfway through the thing or what. Sometimes it's slow, then the next time it goes right through the roof.
Yeah, well, that depends upon the phone line you're calling in on, too.
Two or three minutes? Great. Can you pan that off? And
you see more ice there, Ben?
Yeah, if you don't mind.
Sure, no problem.
Yes, I am. That's very annoying. Kind of makes it hard to think whenever you're... I don't need any help. Yeah, it makes it hard to concentrate whenever I'm hearing myself. It's like I'm on a different page. Thanks.
No problem.
Is the mic okay where it's at?
You're soft spoken, actually.
Well, not by choice.
Oh.
About 10 years ago, I got a knee dropped in my throat and it changed my voice.
And you're screaming and hollering back
for
everybody.
No, I don't scream, man. I figure if, you know, if somebody screams at me, I don't listen. It doesn't work for me, you know. I mean, I think if somebody told me one time that if people, yes. Great. I appreciate that. Somebody told me one time that if people respect your fear, you can whisper, they'll listen. You know, I don't need somebody screaming at me. Somebody screams at me, the first thing I do is shut them off. You know? And that's the same thing that I use in business, too, but it doesn't work for me. I can't scream anyway if I wanted to. It's about as loud as it gets. If I try to get up anymore, it just dies. Well, we'll live with this. If you're worried about that guy, he can whisper, you'll listen. The guy from Denver. Hello, Mark. You in the lovely Mile High City, huh? I hope you're freezing your rear off. Oh well, maybe you'll be miserable next week then. Well, it should. Well, see, you're wrong there. That's exactly what I want you to think, though. I want you to think that I'm smooth and I'm mellow, because that's when the snake strikes you, isn't it? If it was my choice, it would be a mystery match, of course, because that way I get to pick what I want, involve the rules that I want, which there would be none, and then I would also involve a small pet, possibly a 12-foot cobra, which would be significant in the outcome of the match, because somebody would be bitten and someone would be very ill, and possibly me, but I doubt it. I don't care which one it lands on, because I'm prepared to face all of them. I mean, I designed the wheel. I'm very aware of what each match means. Sting's the one that's got to think, just like the people at home. You're the ones that have to think about what I'm going to do next. That's what you've got to wonder about. And the problem with Jake the Snake is nobody knows what he's going to do next. Nobody knows which way I'm going to strike next. Because to have any idea of where I'm headed in my life, you would have to look back and see where I've been. And you don't have a clue as to where I've been and what I've been through. And that's what Sting needs to think about. He should feel like a pigeon right now. I mean, to even for one brief moment think that he has any chance in hell of commanding what I'm going to do in that ring, or dictating what I'm going to do in that ring, he's in for a big, big rude awakening. For him to think that he has an upper hand at any time, wrong. For anyone to think they have an upper hand over Jake the Snake Roberts, dead wrong. You just don't do it. just another place to be. I mean, if you want to ask me about a place that I like, it'd be where I live. I don't like Denver. I don't like Chicago. I mean, I think you got a quarterback that needs to retire, but that's your problem, not mine. Or either that or they need to change coaches, do something, because you guys aren't doing it right. But then again, not many people do. I do. I follow a lot of things. No, not at all. They're not a consistent winner. they seem to choke on the big ones, and I feel like that's the way Sting is, too. Sting will choke when it comes Sunday night. He will out and out choke. When it comes time to pull that switch, man, he's going to be thinking about what his next move in life is going to be. His next move in life will be something other than wrestling. That's a fact. No problem. Yes. What would you like? Okay. Whenever you're ready, tell me. Yo, Dan. Think about something. It's not the Super Bowl, but you still got the Raiders and they bite. And we all know what happens when you guys get to the Super Bowl, don't we? Choke time. Don't choke. Again. Yeah, I hope I never see him. I could, no doubt about that. Yep. Another quickie. Sure. 15-minute break. Yeah, he said it'd be 15 minutes before we did anything else.
I'll just take this off.
You guys hear me? Somebody needs to have a headset on. Like, just one of you guys or whatever. Somebody has to have one.
Is this like good or not? Is this
shitting and it's coming out the mouth and they're shitting and puking in the sink and the shit splattering everywhere. I'm like, fuck, get me off of here. I landed in Fresno at like 5:30, the show started at 7.
Oh, we're happy.
Fuck. You know, it was one of the shortest nights of my career, about a minute and a half. Just pounding. We weren't going to have fun with that. Brutally fast, man. I don't know, sometimes, you know, I get in the mood where I just feel like going out there and messing around for a while, but then you realize it was like playing chess. Yeah. Sometimes you just feel like pulling a big gun out and going,
fuck you.
I think that's about the other thing I'm going to have tonight when I get there, too.
You wrestled in the garden before?
Oh, yeah. It's
a good garden. Is it a good sign?
Yeah, it's not the same. I've wrestled over at the other building too, there with Riverfront or whatever it is.
Coliseum.
Yeah, the Coliseum. It's just, some buildings are designed better for up and people are right down on top of you. And even these buildings, it's like this. God, it's like this. You're a mile away and you really can't see what's going on. It's like we were at the Silverdome. You know, 94,000 people. Well, those people up there couldn't see shit.
I'm watching the jumbo.
There still is the shit, so
yeah. Yeah, it's not the same.
No. What a rush that was. Oh.
2 minutes. Yeah. This format that you really fun to
do. Yeah.
2 minute enter, 1 minute enter.
Basically, yeah.
Yeah. What did you have to tell us
about?
Let me see that replay so I remember how I did.
Oh yeah, I'm going to do that.
What
is he? It's a poison the government outlawed years ago.
Oh yeah.
He was in grade school.
Yeah, probably.
Oh yeah. He was getting the soil and you go to the grass and the cows and the boom and stuff. Yeah. Okay, so is this. You're probably going to call back and I'll let you
Yeah. Hello, Michael.
Yes. Yeah, just not many questions, really, you know. All right. Okay. We'll get annoying then. Como? Is that like a, no, never mind. Seattle. Ugh. Where men are men and the sheep are scared. The great Northwest. Yeah. It's much better. Appreciate that. Yeah, yeah. Us, you know, we'll get into these cities and somebody will be there with a limo and if you there's, you know, next thing you know it's 8 a.m. and if you're going to another city and you get to that city, no, no, there's somebody else. And, oh, you lock yourself in the room and hide. You know, when I was younger it was different. But, 37. I hear you, Graham. Oh, I'm fine, you? Well, Halloween Havoc Sunday night's going to be probably the best night of my career, probably Sting's worst night. Spin the wheel, make a deal. That's an idea of mine, being the sick puppy that I am. And having the idea of ruining somebody's life kind of intrigues me. Even if it was yours, Graham. I mean, you think about it, wrestling is survival. I've been doing it a long time, longer than Sting, and I'll be doing it a lot longer than Sting ever will. But Sunday night, when it comes time for him to spin that wheel, that's when the deal is made, and that's when I'm going to be happy, because all 12 matches are designed basically to end someone's career, not necessarily my own. My idea of a happy ending Sunday night would to see Sting laying flat on his back on that mat, possibly bitten by a king cobra, which I plan on bringing, and you can bet your life that it's going to be there. But as far as Sting goes, Sting has made a bad mistake in agreeing to even do this. I mean, WCW wouldn't even sanction it. They wouldn't even, they didn't want to be responsible to what happened to either athlete. Because all 12 matches on this wheel are designed to end a man's career. It's not like a limbo match or a basketball shooting match. We're talking about barbed wire. We're talking about a coal miner's glove. We're talking about a Texas death match. We're talking about things that are designed specifically to stop a man dead cold. The mystery slot, no doubt about it. The mystery slot, because how do you prepare for that? You got to prepare for what I'm thinking. That's not good for anybody. Not for you in Seattle, not for the people in Philadelphia. Try to figure out where I'm going in my life. You have to see where I've been. That's the bad part, because you haven't a clue as to where I've been in my life and what I've been through. I mean, you think about a child being born to this world today, that child doesn't know how to beg, borrow, steal, rape, kill, anything. Someone's got to teach that child. Unfortunately, I didn't have a very good teacher. Or maybe I had the great teacher, I don't know. It's just the way I have to look at it. But for Sting to look at me and say, I think I can do this, I think I can do that. Big mistake. Big mistake. You never reach out. If a man puts his hand in a fire and it burns him, you don't think that man would do it again, would you? I mean, you just don't, I don't see that as being smart. His position, being idolized, being put on the shelf as WCW's great thing to look at, to being showcased by WCW. I mean, I wasn't even under contract when I attacked him in Baltimore. So that right there should show you what kind of man I am. I'm going to reach out and take exactly what I have to out of life to get what I want and what I need. See, that's the danger line right there. What I need and what I want in life are two different things. But for Sting, unfortunately, he's on that position, he's on that level, he's in that slot as being picked the savior, you know, the new messiah of the WCW. Unfortunately, that's the position I want. And to get it, if it means doing anything at all, or everything, I'll do it. And I won't feel bad about it. So you got a lot of people in prison that have pulled a gun and shot someone, and then 3 or 4 days later they said, gee, I wished I hadn't done that. I feel bad about that. Well, Sting, I got to tell you something up front. If I end your career Sunday night, I'm not going to feel bad about it. Not one moment. If I ruin your life Sunday night, I'm not going to feel bad about it. If there are kids on the aisles crying, or if your own children, if you do have children, if they're crying, I'm not going to feel bad about it. Because once you step into that ring, you belong to me. And you always will. Because I wouldn't have it any other way. Well, maybe a mass murderer, but definitely not a presidential candidate. No, not at all. The things that I want to do in life change daily. I mean, I wake up and I look in that mirror each morning, you know. That's the toughest fight I have in my life. It's not facing a man, it's facing myself, knowing that I've got to keep me happy. Unfortunately, keeping me happy is not easy, because I want so much, and my ideas do change daily, and my needs change daily. So, at times I think that I want one thing, but then it changes. Unfortunately, for those that get in my way, I tend to step on people. I tend to use people. I tend to bite the hand that feeds me often. But that's just the way a snake is. I don't think with the Seahawks it would. No, I definitely want to be on a winning team. I mean, I never have liked losing. I look at Seattle, I see the Mariners, losers. I see the Seahawks, losers. You know, it rains so much up there. I couldn't deal with that. But that has nothing to do with Sunday night. All I'm thinking right now, I am so focused. I am so in tune. All that I want to think about Sunday night is a 12-foot king cobra doing something to somebody. Preferably not me. Hopefully not me. But if it does, I will survive. He's got several names. Just depends what he's doing that day. It's the devil himself. The snake has always been the devil himself. We all know that. He's the one that twisted Eve's arm in the very beginning. The snake has been here forever. And that's the thing about a snake. They do survive. They do survive. You can't trust them, though. Well, I can't agree with you there. I don't think Miami's number one. I definitely don't think Washington's number one. I'm thinking maybe the eighth or ninth slot for both teams. Let's go with Texas A&M. That's a real team. Let's grind out football, man. Let's play some ball. It's easy. I'm a snake. I do what I want. I'm not trying to make you happy, Graham. I'm trying to make myself happy. I don't think anybody could. I think the best thing for the Mariners to do is maybe possibly move to Tampa Bay. That might help them. It might hurt Tampa Bay, but then again, who cares about Tampa Bay or Seattle? You know, I don't own property in either place. But I'm going to own some property in Philadelphia this weekend, Sunday night, because when it comes right down to it, staying when the time comes for me to pull that trigger on that gun, I won't feel bad about it, and I will do it. I just wonder if you will. Well, it depends where that wheel lands. If it's barbed wire, the man's trapped in some barbed wire, tangled up, you know, it's sort of like a calf that's stuck in it, you know, has to squirm around, can't go very far. Every time he moves, it cuts him. That would take some time. If it's a Texas death match, that would take time. Because falls won't count, as many falls it takes, so one man cannot answer the bell. But you think again, coal miner's glove, you get a hold of that glove and you hit somebody, it's over. So who gets the glove first? If it's, you know, there's so many different combinations of matches that you could do. I hear you knocking, but you can't come in. I don't know if you guys in Seattle can hear that, but boy, that was exciting. I guess they must be hearing this interview outside. Depending on the match, the mystery match, it might last forever. But it doesn't matter how long it lasts. I just want to be sure the people in Seattle understand this. Whoever, whatever, it's going to be a slow, painful situation for Sting because he certainly deserves it. Mm-hmm. Bruce. You said Bruce is his name? Bruce King, you think you're the best in the business? Slap yourself and wake up. It's just a bad dream because Jake the Snake Roberts has always been the best in the business and always will be. Let's do it Sunday. I want to do it all Sunday. All right, thank you. Okay. Who the hell was that? Obviously hasn't worked here long. Yeah. Got a bang on the door. You don't know what's going on in here. Thrill seeker. Oh, it's Mayor Barry. No. Not for long. I can hear you. Yeah. Well, if you knew me at all, you'd know how I came up with it. I'm just a sick puppy looking for a way to make somebody else miserable. And this will make somebody else miserable on Sunday night, namely Sting and those who believe in him. Spin the wheel, make a deal. 12 matches designed to end somebody's career. There's not an easy match on there. There's no limbo matches, no basketball shoots or anything like that. These are matches that are designed to put an end to somebody's career. And when you think about getting into a situation with Jake the Snake Roberts where you're involved with me, then you've really got to think about it. Unfortunately, Steve made a bad choice because of his own ego or because of prodding of his people that he thinks believe in him. But Sting has to understand, as soon as he's gone, he will be forgotten. Well, I, at one time or another, have been involved in each one of these matches, whether it was barbed wire, whether it was a coal miner's glove, whether it was a Texas death match, Prince of Darkness. I've done them all. That's where I've got the edge. But there is one special slot on that wheel. It's mystery. A mystery slot where I come up with what I want. Now, if I get a chance, opportunity strikes, and I get to pick what I want, Sting, you can be assured of one thing. It's not going to be pretty. It's going to be real cold. And it's going to be about 12 foot long, a king cobra. And those are not toys that you play with. They're not something you want to give the little kids to play with. Is something that's going to end your career. No doubt about that. That's what this is all about. I want to take the top slot in the WCW and do exactly what I want. You see, to be the best, you have to beat the best. Unfortunately, Sting has been put in that position to be the idol for the children of the WCW, for the fans, to be worshipped. Well, that's my job. My job is to take you out and to give somebody out there a better opportunity to look at somebody that knows something about life itself. That's something I do know, because I've had to fight through it every day. You haven't. Absolutely none. No. Sting's in a bad position. He's more or less just signed his own life away. Because he doesn't understand me. He doesn't know what I've been through in life. He doesn't know how devious I can be. He doesn't know how cold I can be. You see, you got jails all over the country are full of people that wish they hadn't have done something. But Jake the Snake Roberts, any time I've ever done anything in my life, as far as it comes to dealing with another man in the ring, if an injury comes up, too bad. You made the initial mistake by signing it. WCW's not responsible. They made us sign them both off. They don't be responsible for what happens to this man's career, what happened to his life. So therefore, you're giving me the opportunity to do exactly what I want. And that's not going to be good for you, Sting. Sunday night will be the last night of your career. Yep. Nothing personal. I just want the spot. You know, if it was Barry Windham, fine. If it's Dustin Rhodes, fine. It doesn't matter. If it's Ron Simmons, fine. And chances are, it will be one of them after Sting is gone. I mean, I got to pick a new toy to play with. I got to make somebody else miserable. That's the thing about the Snake, you see. He goes out and he chooses what he wants, and then he does what he wants, and then he goes after something else. You see, I have got a thirst that cannot be quenched and a hunger that cannot be satisfied by just one quick meal, by one quick fix. No, it's a lifelong project, a project that doesn't make a lot of people happy, but it makes me happy. Certainly wouldn't make the people in Washington happy. Of course, people in Washington don't have a lot to be happy with anyway. I mean, great mayor, but you got a lot of things going for you, but I'll tell you something, Washington, you don't have anything like the snake does. Nothing. Well, yeah, I guess you could use me in Washington with the choices you've made up there in the past, but no, not politics, man. I'm doing what I want to do in my life, and that's what I'm going to stick with, you know? If it means jerking the rug out from underneath your foot, I'll do it. If it means pushing an old lady out in front of a car, I'll do it. I would not step in front of a car that I was driving, I'll tell you that, because I'm not the kind of guy that's going to walk up and shake your hand and pat you on the back and say, nice job. I'm the kind of guy that's going to walk up, shake your hand, and stab you in the back, and look at you and laugh, and say, nice job. That's just the way a snake is. Kind of reminds me of a story about a rabbit one time that was going down the road, hopping along, and he sees this snake that's been run over by a car, and he helps the snake back to his burrow. He puts him in the burrow, and he says, Mr. Snake, don't worry. I'm going to heal you. I'm going to bring you food and water daily. I'll help you survive. And the snake says, but you can't. I'm a snake. You know that. But the rabbit did it anyway. Nursed him back to health. A few weeks later, the rabbit goes out to get more food and water, comes back, and the snake is gone. I wonder why he left, the rabbit said. He turns around as he comes out of his burrow. What happens? The snake strikes him. And the rabbit says, I can't believe this. I helped you. I saved your life. And the snake calmly said, I told you. The very beginning, I'm a snake. And Sting, I am a snake. And who is George Michael? Oh! George Michael, no doubt in my mind, and there shouldn't be any doubt in your mind why I'm the best. You think about it. Any man that walks on God's green earth today and does exactly what he wants to do when he wants to do it has got to be the very best. And you're looking at it, George. Don't you wish you were? Take care. You like the rabbit story, huh? Okay, Baltimore. No shit. Unbelievable. Y'all need something in there? Well. Yeah, it's just, it's tough to turn it on, man. Sometimes you don't really know what they really want. Hard sell is about me. You get some guys who are great at that, but it kind of reminds me of those cheap furniture sales. Yeah. Before midnight tonight. It's 1 a.m. Oh, it still works?
Baltimore, if you're monitoring, Baltimore, if you're monitoring satellite, we're ready for you. If you want to give us a call.
We just got to get the workout. Got $5 workout. Get out of here.
Yeah, Baltimore, if you're monitoring on satellite, we're ready for you. If you want to give us a call.
Yeah, it's hard to keep training. I mean, if you got to. Without the training, your body doesn't heal. You know, a lot of people get bruised up. They want to sit home with a bruise goes away. You can't do that. You know, you got to get a gym stretched out. Keep the blood flowing through there and move the bruise on, man. Just try to get on down the line. No. I like golf. Yeah, I just started playing last year.
All right, Baltimore, if you're monitoring satellite, you want to give us a call. This is Multimedia Productions, area code 513-381-7100. This is the WCW with Jake the Snake.
He's great. Yeah, I've done that a few times. It's just too tough for me to go out and play for 4.5 hours. It's time to go to work. Hello, Jerry. How you doing? You gotta be miserable. You're in Baltimore. Is Jerry gone? Jerry, what's going on in Baltimore? Oh, I'm fine. I hope you're miserable. No, that's a change for Baltimore.
which is about 300 days. Snake's always doing fine. He takes care of himself. I replace him daily. I'm here. Hello? I'm talking to you. I can hear you, but you evidently can't hear me. All right, you hear me. I don't count. I feel like I'm here to do something. They're there to do something, and as long as they do their end, they're fine. If not, we'll make a pair of boots. That's just the way a snake is, though, isn't it? You gotta use. I'm a people user. Well, there's not a good choice, but if I was going to go with anybody, it's got to be Clinton, because I'm tired of Bush. I mean, I don't like people that say one thing and do another. See, I've always considered myself a prick of sorts, but an honest one. And that's something that Bush has not been, as an honest man. See, I can deal with somebody that's a liar. I can deal with somebody that's a thief. But I cannot deal with people that just continually tell you one thing and then do another. Oh, how are we doing this, and what is going on? Are we okay now? It's nice to be found. Unfortunately, it won't be so nice for Sunday night for Sting. No, it's not. He wouldn't have as big a chance as the Sting that I'm dealing with Sunday night's going to have. And he's not going to have much of a chance of it all, because you think about what he's gotten himself into. You don't play a snake without expecting to be bitten sooner or later. And it's time for the bite to come down. And once the bite comes down, though, you don't walk away from this. Well, a coal miner's glove, of course, is a very heavy glove. Of course, when you're digging coal, you need that. I've never dug any coal, but I know what a glove is, and I've used it. It's one great weapon. It's a leaded glove. Keeps you from getting your hands crushed when you're dealing with coal. The glove will be put on a 15-foot pole in a corner. The first man that gets up that pole and gets a hold of that glove and comes down there can use it on his opponent. That's not healthy. But then again, there's not a match on here that is healthy, Jerry. You think about it, Texas Death Match, Bob Wire Match. Can you imagine being trapped in some Bob Wire, having that stuff? No, it's not good. It's not like you're taking a walk to the office here. It's not going to be a good day for anybody involved in the match. I don't expect to go in there and not be injured. I've always expected the worst. That way, when something good happens, I can really enjoy it. But for Sting has made the biggest mistake of his life, because he has no idea what I'm capable of doing, and capable of what this mind is thinking about at times. I mean, sometimes I don't sleep at night because I just lay there and think of these strange things that you can do to somebody. We're talking career-ending injury. That's what we're talking about, because unfortunately Sting has been put in a position by the WCW as to be their matinee idol, if you want to say, whatever, or they're marketing him, and that's the position that I wanted. When I attacked him in Baltimore in August, I wasn't even under contract with WCW. I just went out there and I said, hey, this is the spot I want, and this is the spot I'm taking. Now, I had a choice at that time. They could arrest me, or they could sign me. They signed me. Why did they sign me? I'll tell you why. I'm a proven product. They know that when Jake the Snake goes in that ring, he gets the job done. Regardless of what the situation is, I get the job done. People may not like me, people may like me. I don't care, that's not what I'm about. I'm not out there with a popularity contest. Sting is. That's the mistake. It is, because... The quick kill. Whether it's you, whether it's the guy next to me, or the guy behind the camera, whatever it takes. I'm willing to do that. I don't think Sting is. You see, there's a lot of people in jail, Jerry, that they've had that gun in their hand, and they've reached out, and they pointed that gun at somebody, and they pull that trigger. Then 3 or 4 days later, they go, oh, man, I wished I hadn't done that. Jake the Snake has never backed up once and said, gee, I wished I hadn't have done that to that guy. Not once. And I've put a lot of people through a lot of pain. But then again, like I said in the beginning, if you're going to play the Snake, sooner or later you got to expect to be bitten. And Sunday night, Halloween Havoc. What a pretty day to do it, huh? I think it fits perfectly. Why not? I won't need the luck. Got it. All right. You got it. All right. That guy was totally...
Did you tell him that it's not the rock scene that you're wrestling?
No. Sportscaster, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, sports machine or something.
Yeah, okay, that guy.
Yeah, that's the one. How if I know? Get the Eli in Detroit. Greg, this is Jake the Snake. I'm not a villain. I'm probably the nicest person you'll ever meet. Trust me. You think about it. All this stuff you guys out in LA are going through, maybe I should run as a police chief or something out there. I can get the job done. Better than some people. Well, then you're a very smart man to remember that. You see, most people aren't that smart. Most people will sit there and let me draw them right in and snap on them again. You've been doing your homework. Spin the wheel, make the deal. That's the whole deal, Greg. It's a situation where you have 12 matches. Each match is designed not as a limbo contest or shooting basketballs. We're talking about 12 matches that could end your career, and most likely one of them will in Sting's career or my own. But don't bet on it. You look at these matches, you think about them. They're a Texas Death Match, there's a Coal Miner's Glove Match, Prince of Darkness Match. barbed wire. There's a little bit of everything for everybody. But there's one special slot. Mystery. Don't you love a mystery? I always have. The problem is, Sting, if that thing lands on it, I get to dictate what the match is going to be about. And there's no doubt in my mind, if it's up to me, there'll definitely be a snake involved, other than myself, a scaly one. Maybe a 12-footer. I've got a real nice 12-foot King Cobra that would really look good hooked up to him. What's fair in life? You ever had a fair day in your life? And when you think about it, a child is born, does not know how to rape, steal, rob, cheat, lie. Somebody teaches these kids to do this stuff. So what's fair in life? I don't know fair. Fair is survival to me. If it means jumping on you, Greg, that's what I've got to do. If it means beating up Sting, that's what I've got to do. I mean, the toughest fight in my life is not the man that I'm facing. It's that man that I've got to look at in the mirror every morning and say, gee, did I like what I did last night, you know? I mean, you guys out there have jails full of people that have pulled a trigger on a gun, then 3 or 4 days later said, gee, I wished I hadn't done that. I've never felt sorry for injuring anybody in a ring in my life. Because once you sign that dotted line, then it's your mistake. It's your mistake for being in that position with me. Halloween Havoc. Sting has made his last mistake as a professional wrestler. Unfortunately for him, it's not a personal thing. It's not whether I like Sting or I dislike Sting. I dislike what he stands for. Eat your vitamins, say your prayers, and everything's going to work out all right? No, that's not the way it is. If people would be more honest with their children today, they wouldn't have the problems in this world today that we have. But yet you've got some mom or dad sitting back saying, well, gosh, you know, you eat your vitamins, you say your prayers, you go to school, you get married, you're going to live happily ever after. What a crock. That's a crock, man. If you tell this kid, hey, he's going to have to bust his butt every day of his life, or he's going to watch the guy next to him who's going to shaft him, or he's got to watch his old lady because she's going to cheat on him. Now you got a kid that might make it in this life. I'm that kid. I'm that one that says, I'm not going to let anybody else step on me. I'll step first. If it means biting the hand that feeds me, then so be it. That's just the way it's got to be. I think Sting has had a pampered life. I'm not saying the man does not earn the position that he's in because he is a great athlete. No doubt about that. But whether if it was Sting, it's Sting. If it's Ron Simmons, it's Ron Simmons. All I'm saying is I want the position. I want that top spot. And if it means wasting Sting, they shoot horses, don't they? Yeah, they do. I always have. Don't you think I do? Yeah. Good answer. Smart answer. You won't get a snake in the mail. Yeah. Now, for how long? Ah, see, there's the question again. When you guys pay me. I don't expect anything from anybody. I'm just saying, all I'm saying, and whenever I say I'm not getting a check from someone, is you don't make me what I am. You don't take care of Jake the Snake. Jake the Snake has to take care of himself. That's just the way life is. I mean, you might have somebody that hand feeds you, I don't know. But nobody has ever done that for me. And I don't want anybody to. Because I'm willing to reach out there and take what I need off that table. Am I? When I'm making somebody else miserable, yes. No doubt about that. No doubt at all. Oh, you mean, do I like to take a walk in the park and watch the birds? Not necessarily. There are things in life I enjoy, no doubt about that. But that's personal time. Sunday night's not personal time. Sunday night's business time. Halloween Havoc, that's business. And I know when I walk out of that dressing room that I've got to take it all in business and be prepared to sacrifice anything and everything that I have available. That's smart. That is smart. I mean, if you're applying for a job, do you tell the guy there's somebody else out there better than you? I don't think so. No. You tell him you're the best there is. Well, Jake the Snake Roberts is the best. No doubt about that. Always has been, always will be. Do it, Greg. All right. I want to talk to Eli. Okay. You ought to fire the prick. He's not there. Brian. Eli's not coming. Snake's always here. I'm doing great. Brian, yourself? Well, we're not going to make Eli happy, whoever he was. I hope he's been axed. Halloween Havoc. Pretty simple. Right? I mean, you think about it. There's 12 matches on this wheel. You spin the wheel, wherever it lands, we're going to do whatever that wheel says. If it's a coal miner's glove match, then we'll put the coal miner's glove on a pole and we'll go for it. If it's a barbed wire match, then they're going to surround the ring with barbed wire and we'll go for it. I'd hate to be trapped in barbed wire, wouldn't you, Brian? This doesn't sound like much fun to me. I mean, I've seen animals before caught up in it and struggling and cutting. But no, that wouldn't be my favorite. But each match, Brian, is designed to end a man's career. There's no limbo match on there. Not one. There's no easy. No, I'm not into limbo. I don't see how a man can get injured doing that. See, the whole purpose of spin the wheel, make the deal, is to end somebody's career. Now, a lot of people say, well, Jake, that's not a very fine thing to do. Well, I really don't care what anybody thinks about what Jake the Snake's doing, because Jake the Snake knows what he wants to do in his life. And whatever I've got to do to get there, then I'll do it. If it means putting Sting up and finishing him off, that's what it has to happen. Now, next week, it might be somebody else, Sting, so don't feel bad. I mean, if you're out of a job, Sting, and you can't wrestle anymore, just be safe in knowing that you don't have to worry about me bothering you anymore, because once you're through wrestling, I don't want any more of you. So it might be Ron Simmons next week. But for this week, for Sunday night, it's you, Sting. Unfortunately for you, you've been in a position with the WCW to be that idol that's sitting on top of the whole heap, that's got the marketing behind him, that's got everybody patting him on the back, the fair-haired boy, if you see what I'm saying. That's what I'm trying to tell you. You've been hand-fed. You're a great athlete, no doubt about that. But you're the man on top. And anytime you're the man on top, then you got to watch out for people like me. Yeah. Well, I don't know what kind of magazines you're reading. Maybe you're reading comics. You must be reading comics. Well, some of those are pretty funny. It says Jake shouldn't what? And why do they base that? Maybe that's why they're reporters and not wrestlers. It couldn't. There's no way in the world that any man can beat me in 10 minutes. None. You see, each match is not designed to go forever. Each match is designed to end a man's career. And I just do not feel like Sting has that killer instinct. I think he's too much of a... He's just too soft. You see, there's a lot of jails full of people that will pull a trigger on a gun, and 3 or 4 days later are going to feel bad about doing it. Well, Jake the Snake Roberts never felt bad about doing it. If I hurt someone out there, I hurt him. If the snake bites him, then the snake bites him. That's why they call him the Snake. But to understand in life that when you step into the ring with a snake, you've got to expect to be bitten. And Sting needs to think about that. I don't think he understands just how much and how far I'll go to get what I want. If it means jumping the guy that's sitting behind this camera, that's what I'll do. If it means coming to Detroit, and I hate to do that, because, I mean, after all, the Lions, what happened to those guys? Those guys shouldn't be playing football. They could use some. They could use a lot. They could use a lot, but unfortunately for them, I'm not into that. I'm into this. And for a reporter to sit back and say, I have no business in the ring, I'd sure like to shake his hand one time. But then again, there aren't those... There are those that report the news, and there are those that make the news. And Jake the Snake makes the news. No doubt about that. When I do something, people stand up and they look at me and they say, man, that dude is sick. If that dude knows where he's going. You see, I've fought all my life. It's not been easy. And I'm not asking for anybody to pat me on the back and tell me it's going to be all right tomorrow, because it's not. It's going to be the same fight tomorrow as it is today. In life, to be totally honest, expect the worst. Always expect the worst. Do not believe for one moment that you're going to grow up and live happily ever after, because that's just not the way it happens. You've got to go out there and you've got to fight for it day after day after day, and never let your guard down, because the second you let that guard down, somebody's going to rip you. That's brutally honest. Is there any doubt in your mind? These guys aren't good politicians, much less fighters. You got one guy that says all he did was smoke it, he didn't inhale it. I mean, come on. Then you got another guy that says he's not going to raise the taxes, but then he does. Then you got another guy that can't make up his mind if he wants to run or not. Pulls out this month, come back in this month. Doesn't matter. At least Jake the Snake Roberts knows where he's headed. But for you to know where I'm headed, you would have to see where I've been. And you can't do that. Nobody. Not near far enough. I got to go a whole lot further to make me happy, Brian. I mean, some people in life, maybe they don't want much, or maybe they're just easily satisfied. Well, I have a thirst that can't be quenched and a hunger that will not be satisfied. Whether that's the force that drives me, I don't know. Maybe it is, maybe it's not. All I know is to keep this snake happy daily. Daily, I must do something and feed off something. Whatever adrenaline rush it is, that's what I've got to do. And Sunday night, the rush that I'm going to get is finishing Sting. Well, Jake the Snake's got a long history of never being lazy. That's not in my character. For some reason, Jake the Snake has always been that razor's edge, if you will, that rides it hard, rides it long too, you know, just keeps pushing. Never satisfied. Never being satisfied is the key to success. You get some people, they open up a little pizza store, you know, the next thing you know, they buy a baseball team, but they're not happy. So what do? They sell it to another pizza owner, and that guy's not happy either. But the deal with Jake the Snake is daily, I've got to do something to make me happy. Letting my hands down to my side would not make me happy. Making somebody else miserable would make me happy. Whether it's Sting or Ron Simmons or Dustin Rhodes, whoever it happens to be, it's just another notch on the gun, another day in paradise with Jake the Snake Roberts. Myself, because I don't know what I'm going to do next. That's scary. Just not sure. I'd be good. Yep. Yeah. Good. How much time, Mike, before we do another one? Oh, okay. Okay.
13 more minutes.
Mike must be. All right. I can barely hear somebody. How you doing, Mike? Not recently. Not long enough. There's something in life that's not very funny about being harassed or being railroaded through anything. Yeah, well, you know, sometimes you get people put in a position that thinks it's entertaining to abuse someone. Well, they got theirs. Time comes back around, they'll get it again. We all pay for it sooner or later, don't we? Yeah. Wrong. Totally wrong. No. Have no personal feelings at all for the man. The situation, Mike, is he's been put on this pedestal in WCW and been proclaimed as a fair-haired boy and been marketed, and millions are being made. Other words, he's got the top slot. That's what I want. When I attacked the man in Baltimore, everybody's like, why did you jump on Sting? Why did you do that? Why not? If he's got the top spot, I want the top spot, then I've got to take it. I mean, if there's one steak on the table, Mike, and it's you eat or I eat, you're going to be hungry tonight because I want to eat. You can bet on that. And Sunday night, I will get my fill and so will Sting. Unfortunately for Sting, he's going to pull that lever. He spins a wheel. We make the deal. Whatever match it should land on, that's what we got to do. I do not think that he is prepared to make the same sacrifices that I am. Well, it's like this. If you know how to dance, you can dance. I know how to dance. I've done all these matches before, so I'm one up there. You see, Sting let this thing become personal for him because he felt like I was out just to get him. I'm not out to get Sting. I'm out to get the slot. Now, that slot happens to be the top one. So what Sting has to think about here is, well, how far will Jake the Snake Roberts go in getting what he wants? I'll go as far as I have to. The mystery match. There's a slot for a mystery match. In other words, it would be up to me to name what I want. Well, if I told you, it wouldn't be much of a mystery now, would it? Huh? I'll tell you what. Being that you're from Orlando, one of my favorite cities. Yeah. I'll tell you this. Yeah, I bet they would. I bet they would. Fat chance. The thing about the mystery match, Mike, is I'll give you this much. It will involve a 12-foot cobra. Just something to think about, for Sting to think about. Because I'm willing to take that chance that that snake won't get me first. It would get him. That's how far I'm willing to go for this. Snake will be back. You know, a snake always has his day, and I'm just saying that Sunday night will be my day and my night, and I feel confident in what I'm doing. And if Sting thinks for one brief moment he's a better man than I am, he's sadly mistaken, and Sunday night will be his last match. All right, Mike. Sometime. John in San Diego. All right. Yes. This gets so repetitious, man. You gotta say the same thing to these same people. You know? If you had a room full of reporters, you could answer once.
You're going to have a constant problem with the
Hey.
You don't want to be on the plane.
Got that right, brother. 26,000 miles up here. Why so far? All the globe. We must be near. Well, what an echo. What an echo I've got. Are they? It sounded like it. That was brutal. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, be there. I slapped a guy down there 4 years ago. 10 years probation. No. Giving a guy a ride, it was, Dr. Duke. David Schultz. Yeah, he slapped Stossel's. Yeah, I slapped the guy, gave me 10 years probation. Unbelievable. Railroad job all the way. Yeah, it's unreal. Talking about 160 grand cash. No witnesses, no nothing. But you're guilty. Yeah. If I'm on television? No. Yeah, met a guy in a bar, give him a ride. We're going to a different bar. Driving along, just drunk. I'm not scared of you. I did a Marine, I did this. Not what I'm in. I'm in that good. Boom, he hits me. You know? Boom, he hits me again. Pull over, I'm like, don't do it. I know the guy's got me by the hair trying to pull me out of the car. He goes to swing at me, I block it. Do this, boom, and falls on his butt, starts laughing, points his finger at me, jumps up and runs off. What is this? What is this? 48 hours later, he goes to a civil lawyer, draws up his statement, takes it to police, aggravated battery. Yes. Okay. Then he goes to the hospital. Broken cheekbone, crushed eyesight. Hello, John. John, are you there? Can I? We have a problem? Are we fixed yet? This is Jake the Snake Roberts. I'm looking for John in San Diego. I'm not getting John. Something is wrong. I'm still here, Jake's still here. All right, San Diego. Tune in Sunday night, Halloween Havoc. Sting's last match. You're going to get the chance to see it if you pay the price. Spin the wheel, make the deal. Good luck. You're going to need it.